Hello and welcome to another OC Detectives tutorial. Today we're going to be using Adobe Illustrator to create 3D shapes from simple 2D drawings. Before we get into the session, be sure to hit the subscribe button and click like if you enjoy my content. Let's get straight into it. Okay, so when you open up an Illustrator project, you want to go to the Shape tool and draw a shape on your canvas. What I'm doing now is I'm selecting an ellipse shape, holding down Shift to create a perfect circle. Next, I want to get rid of the stroke. So I'm going over to the stroke area and I've reduced that to 0. And I'm just changing the fill to a color of choice. You could choose any color. It doesn't really matter for this. So I'd like to cut my circle in half. So to do that, I've selected the rectangle tool this time, and without holding shift to make a perfect square, I'll create a rectangle shape that covers half of the circle. Next, we grab the selection tool and highlight both shapes, and then we go to the Pathfinder and select remove front from the back. So now we're left with a perfect semicircle. All that's left to do is to allow Adobe Illustrator to work its magic. Go to Effects, select 3D and Materials, click Revolve, and allow Illustrator to do this. So here's another example of me using the pen tool, and I go to Effects, 3D and Material, and then select Revolve. Effects, 3D and Material, and then Revolve. Okay, so now that we have our 3D shape and we are focused on the Revolve tool this time, let's have a look at some of the features and the things that can be done to the shape to change its features. So we have materials, we have lighting, we can change it from standard to diffuse, we can change the position from the top right to the top left where the light's coming from. We also have other options when it comes to the light itself. We can adjust the intensity of the light. We can adjust the rotation of the light using the rotation toggle. And we can adjust the height, how far away the light is from the actual object. And we can adjust the softness and hardness as well as the ambient light as well. Okay, so now let's have a look at the materials. You always start off with the default base material, but there are a number of different options you can choose from. And you can select the ray tracing box there at the top right, and that will allow you to see a more realistic render of the 3D object in real time. If you have a slower machine, it's recommended that you turn that option off. But once you've chosen the ray tracing option, you can select the different types of materials. You can see me here selecting through some of these different materials that come already with Adobe Illustrator. They are inbuilt. Naturally, if you have an Adobe stock account, you can add as many types of 3D materials that you would like that are available in Adobe stock. From some of the options that aren't there is are clear plastic. You have options such as clear glass. I think it's called watery glass, rainy glass, but lots of different types of materials available in Adobe stock for you to download. And once you've selected a material, you can see you can adjust the roughness. You can adjust its appearance of being a metallic object as well. So you can drag the slider and move that up and down, and you can see that it just takes the shine off. As you increase the roughness, it takes the reflectiveness of the light off. So the smoother it is, the more shine that you'll see. And you can see the metallic option kind of gives it the appearance that it's more metallic. So again, looking at the ray tracing options, you can see that you can have it as low, medium, or high quality, and you can reduce the noise, and you can render it as a vector, and you can remember these settings and apply to all the 3D objects that you add. And naturally, as I said before, this will affect the speed of your computer if you're running on a slow machine. So that is it for this tutorial regarding using the 3D tool to make a 2D shape and revolve that shape to create a 3D object. I've shown you plenty of examples of how to do that. So all you're watching now is just my design process of how I came up with the image that you saw. If you've seen the post that I posted on Instagram, and if you're not following me on Instagram, get on Instagram and follow me at OC's Tech Tips. This is how I made it, albeit in a sped up version. You'll see me here just multiplying the shapes, selecting each one of the shapes, changing the colors here and there. Now I'm kind of taking the shine off, reducing the amount of shine on each one of them, adding some text, turning the text into 3D. And then because you could do the same thing that you would with a shape with the with text as well. And that is it. Thank you so much for watching. Again, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Click here if you'd like to watch a tutorial on how to use the neon glow effect in Adobe Illustrator to create a Captain America style neon shield. And click here for some of this tip. Take care, and I'll see you next time. OC's Tech Tips.